Hi, I'm Paddy. As you can see here, new digs. I've been kicked out of my palatial upstairs man cave and down here into the garage. We have a house guest, you see, who might be here for quite some time, so we figured we might set up down here so I can still make videos and not be silenced like last time we had a house guest. But we're talking about getting a backdrop so you don't have to look at, what, there's a doll there and I don't know, some other crap in the background hanging around. But anyway, Alice Cooper. I'm a big Alice Cooper fan. I love me some Alice. He's got some news today. Now, I'm not usually a news peddler. I like to talk about the songs and music and whatnot. But there's a news peddler. Kane Roberts has rejoined the Alice Cooper after 24 years. Now, Kane was the geezer who joined Alice after the Dada album, and they made two albums together. One was Constrictor, and the other one was Raise Your Fist and Yell. Now, just recently, just getting sidetracked here, but just recently, on the Ultimate Classic Rock website, list of Alice Cooper albums from best to worst, Raise Your Fist and Yell was actually rated the worst. The worst Alice Cooper album. Now, I say, if that's genuine and people actually think that that's the worst album, then, you know, that sets a pretty high quality bar for music if that's your worst album. Personally, I think Trash was the worst Alice Cooper album. It's appropriately named and appropriately photographed on the cover. But, like, as I say, we're getting sidetracked. Kane Roberts joined for the Constrictor album. At that point, the gap between the Dada album, which came before, which was a dark, brooding masterpiece of an album, very, very dark, was not in any way could be classified as hard or heavy rock. It was theatrical, it was dark, and it was wonderful. I loved Dada. But Alice was in a very bad way physically when he recorded both Dada and the album preceding that, Zipper Catches Skin. He was he doesn't even remember, apparently. He says quite regularly that he doesn't even remember recording those two albums. I'd like to see Dada played some on stage, to be honest. I think it would be great. But yeah, he the longest gap up to that point between Dada and Constrictor, that was the longest gap of Alice's career in terms of putting out albums, because he was very, very ill and close to death. And so that was kind of a comeback of sorts after 3 years. I think it was a 3-year gap between Dada and Constrictor. And he had this young man called Kane Roberts playing guitar on him. Now, Kane Roberts is a huge... He was Lou Ferrigno. Think Lou Ferrigno from The Incredible Hulk. And Kane may have even been a whisker bigger than that. It certainly looks that way in the videos, but it's hard to tell. He's a big, big man. And he looked kind of awkward playing the guitar. It looked because he was so... It looked kind of awkward. But boy, could he play. And he was also very theatrical. The tour for the Constrictor album was called The Nightmare Returns, and that was when Alice went back from the dark Dada type music that he was doing for a few albums to theatrical hard rock that he began with. And Constrictor had their single on it from He's Back, which was a song from a Friday the 13th movie. I can't remember which one. There were so many of them. Let's just say Friday the 13th part 678. That's pretty close, I'd imagine. But yeah, that was the soundtrack, He's Back, The Man Behind the Mask. And it was also served as a double thing, because Alice himself was back. I'm back and here I am. And it was a good song. The music may have sounded a little like Styx's Too Much Time on My Hands from the Paradise Theatre album. Got to check myself on that before I go on. I'm pretty sure it was Paradise Theatre. Had Too Much Time on My Hands on it. The music was very similar in that keyboard-orientated driving. So, yeah, that was a great album, Constrictor. But as for Raise Your Fist and Yell, it too was a great album. I don't know why it would be voted or selected to be the worst album of Alice's career. That's a mystery to me. But you can look that up for yourself, if you like, on the Ultimate Classic Rock website. Alice Cooper's Raise Your Fist and Yell is his worst album. I find it hard to believe. But anyway, people have different choices. My favourite song on Raise Your Fist and Yell is Roses on White Lace. Now, it's part of a trilogy of songs, a conceptual trilogy. It's three in a row joined together. Gale, Chop Chop Chop, Gale and Roses on White Lace. Now, Roses, I think I've described this before, Roses on White Lace is the most sinisterly, the most beautifully sinister song that Alice has ever done. And it remains to this day. Although he says that a song he did on his last album was the darkest song he's ever done. I think Roses on White Lace is close to the darkest song he's ever done. And this is a guy who sang about dead babies. So, yeah, I think Roses on White Lace is a jewel in his crown. And I believe he's been doing it, well, I don't know about this last tour that he's on now, but I believe he did it recently on stage as part of his set, Roses on White Lace, which is long overdue, very popular among the fans. And being in the garage, there's insects. You've probably seen, I don't know if you can see the insects, but yeah, one's going to fly out my nose in a minute. I'm going to be all, you know, nosy. So let's have a look at a lyric video I found on YouTube for Roses on White Lace. We'll come back and have a little bit of a spiel, and that'll be about it. So check this out, Roses on White Lace. This is featuring Alice Cooper and his guitarist Kane Roberts, who by this time Kane Roberts was much more in the swing than he was with Constrictor. I suspect because he was not only big physically, but he has also a very big character, and he was probably starting to assert a little bit more influence over the songs. This is just speculation. I don't know. I wasn't there. I have no idea. But it feels to me like the Roses on White, the progression from Constrictor to Raise Your Fist and Yell was probably down to a lot down to Kane Roberts. And I was always disappointed he didn't do a third album with Alice, because the next album after this was Trash, and it was, appropriately named. I think that's probably close to the worst album of Alice's. I think it's way in the top bottom, if you will, five, along with Pretty's For You and Easy Action. In fact, they're the only three that I really don't like. Pretty's For You, Easy Action, and Trash. But anyway, have a listen to Roses on White Lace. There we go. So, roses on white lace. Tell me that isn't beautiful, beautifully sinister with the, you know, the images of blood drops on a wedding dress and a scunned person whose face is hidden away. And, oh, yeah, that's some nasty shit. But, yeah, that's all. That's not only my favourite song on the Raise Your Fist and Yell album, it's probably one of my favourite Alice songs, period. It's got great drive and it's got great Alice-y lyrics and, yeah. But like I said, it was downhill for an album or two after that, and then before he re-got the rock groove that he had happening. But it's interesting that Kane Roberts is back in the band after 24 years, because as Alice said recently himself, he's got an album just about ready to go, which means it's probably already recorded and they're just doing the whatever fiddly shit they do after it's recorded. So I'm wondering if Kane's going to overdub those album, that particular album that's finished. Because it would be a shame if Kane rejoined the band just on the cusp of an album coming out that probably, I think, features Nita Strauss, his last guitarist, Nita, who was phenomenal. She was prodigious. She was prodigious. She was wonderful. I'm wondering why she left, but she hasn't said. But not only did she pull out of Alice's immediate future dates, she also cancelled a lot of her own that she had. So she hasn't said if there's anything wrong, and she's actually said there wasn't. So I don't know. It's none of my business. It's a bit sad that Nita left, because she was also good. Alice has always had good guitarists. And I'm wondering if, like I said, Kane will be on the forthcoming album that Alice said is almost ready to go. And then he's been working on another album after this, a second one, which I imagine Kane will be on if he's joined for the long term. I haven't read anywhere on any of the press releases that he's doing any more than standing in. I mean, I don't know if he's just standing in until Alice gets a permanent replacement, or whether Kane is back in the fold for the foreseeable future. I really don't know, but I know that right now Kane's back, and that's a good thing, because the tour for the Raise Your Fist and Yell album was very, very much a Kane and Alice show. It wasn't just Alice, look at me, look at me. It was look at us, look at us. So Kane took a much bigger role, and I think that's a good thing. I hope he does that again. He also has done a number of solo albums, Mr. Roberts, the last one of which I forget the name, if I'm being honest, but I did get an autographed copy of it from his website when it came out, and I won't say it set my heart on fire or set me ablaze or anything like that, but it was a solid album with, you know, many, many varied twists and turns, but I don't think it was something I could really get my choppers into. But he did have an album also. Was it called Sinners and Saints, or Saints and Sinners, or something along those lines? That was a good album that Kane Roberts did. I think that was after he left Alice the first time. But anyway, Kane's back and Paddy's happy, so I'm hoping that they can recapture that fire, because if you look at the Nightmare Returns, which is a live concert video recorded on the Constrictor tour, there was definitely a magic there between them. They had the it factor going on, and I'm glad that he's back, and I hope that he stays for the foreseeable future. That'll be great. So there's Roses on White Lace, and there's my spiel about Kane Roberts rejoining Alice Cooper's band. Like I said, I don't usually do news, but I was particularly excited by that and wanted to share it with you all. So thanks for watching, and we'll talk again real soon. Bye.